Hello, Dr. Ron Eglin, and today we're going to do some dragging and some dropping. I'm here inside of JS Fiddle. We are going to do the work that we're going to do here with JavaScript. And I will make a note that I am using jQuery 1.9.1. I'm actually doing this using jQuery. And I am using one external resource within JS Fiddle, which is jQuery UI. I actually have a link to the external resource of jQuery UI. I'll jump over here to the jQuery UI page. The jQuery UI page has a number of really nice, fun, handy tools. And jQuery UI is an add-in tool for jQuery that gives you some functionality, some specific user interface functionality, and it's relatively straightforward and easy to use. And it has nice examples. But I'm going to give you an example here of how to implement drag and drop using jQuery and jQuery UI. Now that doesn't mean it's the only way to do it. Other tools handle drag and drop, just specifically working with this tool. So let's look and see what I'm going to do here. I'm going to go ahead and run this. If I deal a card, and if you've been looking at my other examples, you see me deal decks of cards. In this case, I'm only dealing one card, and I'm going to drop it into my drop area. And notice it says, ID Ace of Hearts was dropped onto me. Okay, so in other words, I dropped the Ace of Hearts onto that drop area. Okay, it's still actually droppable. I didn't remove the draggable capability of this, but let's look and see how that was all done. Okay, so I'm going to move this over here a little bit. The HTML itself is really straightforward. I have a button to deal the card, and if you've watched some of my other lectures, you may see that I've done that before. And then I have an area that's a div called drop with the class drop. And drop really just has a width, a height, and a background color. It doesn't need to actually float left. I did float it left here. So that's real straightforward HTML and CSS. That gives you the whole start part, the beginning of what the HTML looks like. Now let's look at the JavaScript. Well, the first thing that I did is I set it so that on the load, it's going to go ahead and run init, the function that I've named init, that piece of jQuery code will run the initialization code. And the initialization code only really does one thing here. It creates the drop area to be droppable and sets a function to handle the drop. Now, because it's using the dot drop, it's actually using a class designation, a CSS class designation for that droppable capability. So in theory, anything that has the class drop, any div or whatever that uses the class drop, will be a droppable area of your screen. Because that $.drop will actually select all of the drop areas that are that you've defined. So that's what the jQuery selector, that's a jQuery selector, it selects an object. And that droppable says, okay, make this stuff droppable and handle the drop with this handle drop event, which is a function. Now, I also have here the $.deal click function deal card. So basically when the click event is triggered on any object with the name .deal, which is, by the way, the button that's right here, okay, it's going to call the function deal card. So let's look at that function deal card. Let's make it a little bit bigger so we can fit it here. What does it do? Well, creates an image, okay, creates an image element. It sets it equal, the source of that image element, equal to an actual picture that I have on a server. It sets the ID equal to Ace of Hearts. So that image does have an ID, and then it puts it on the actual body of the HTML. So appends the child image. So that simply shows the card. It actually creates the image and shows the card in that image element. All right, the last thing it does is because I set the ID to be Ace Hearts, it calls the function draggable on the element. Remember, here's a jQuery selector. It calls the function draggable on the element that's selected through this jQuery here. Remember, in jQuery, that $ gives you that ability to do a selector if you've been working with jQuery. So that's what happens. So now that actual card, that image file, is draggable. Now the last thing that we're going to do here is we're going to go ahead and handle the drop event. I'll move this up. Okay, handle the drop event. What happens here? Well, I need to call this, but you already know that I call it because I created the droppable, okay, which was the div that was actually given the class dot drop. So anything that has the class dot drop is going to actually handle the drop event with the function handle drop event. So the event and the UI are passed over here. So you set the draggable equal to the object of UI, the draggable element, and the draggable element is the element that you picked up and started dragging. Okay, that's the actual thing that you're dragging around. So if, okay, you want to, what I'm going to do here next is really simple. Okay, and I actually have an extra piece of code in here that I didn't remove, the document.body.remove child, which I didn't use, and actually would amaze that it didn't cause an error. But this last piece of code right here, what it does is it says, okay, dot pound drop. Well, what is pound drop? Pound drop is the div element, because that's the ID that I gave to it. I set the HTML in it that says the square with ID. It's actually a card with ID, not a square. Draggable with the attribute ID. Okay, draggable is the element that you're dragging around, and you want to get back the ID attribute of that element, which, by the way, is ace hearts, was dropped onto me. Okay, so in other words, you're changing the HTML of this to say this. Now, we can go over here and I can actually make some changes in phase. The beauty of working with JS Fiddle is you can make changes and see immediately what happens here. So first, I gotta get rid of this. This does not belong. Okay, get rid of that remove child piece. It doesn't belong here. And you know what? Square, that's a card. CARD. Now I'm gonna run it again. Okay, let's go over here so we can see it. Okay, I'm gonna deal the card. There's that card. I'm gonna drag it into there and see the card with ID ace hearts was dropped onto me, and it all works nice and pretty. So now you've got the ability to dynamically create an image element, drag it onto a drop area, and trigger an event. That's a lot of capability there. So hopefully this will help you with all your dragging and dropping. Good programming.